Hi all, welcome to this session. I know you're all busy at work, but let DataBots do some of your IT chores. This is Tejo, Senior Director of Product Management at Cloud Fabrics. I lead our product management and roadmap for AIOps, observability, and automation solutions. And I'm very passionate about solving some of our customer problems with some of the emerging technologies that we are bringing to the market today. And I am also fortunate to be part of great companies like Cisco and Topspin earlier. Just a quick note about Cloud Fabrics. We are one of the leading AIOps vendors in the industry. And what we do is we enable IT organizations to be modernized with AI, ML, and smart automation technologies. We are based out of Pleasanton, California, and we do have some differentiated technology offerings. We have an AI ops platform. We have observability in a box solution. And also we have asset intelligence and robotic data automation. And RDA is going to be the focus of today's session. And all of these solutions we have built on a microservices and containers-based architecture, and our solutions can be deployed on-prem or on cloud. So I have a few modules to go over today, starting with the introduction and overview. If you see the modern IT, it's very complex, right? So you have many different systems that you have observability tools, you have alerts and events getting generated, you have ITSM systems, collaboration tools, automation tools, spread across your on-prem, your edge environments, and your cloud and SaaS applications. Now, how do you deal with all of this complexity, right? And if you see some of the limitations with current automation tools today, they are pretty much siloed, right? So you have infrastructure automation tools, you have release automation, or you have CI/CD automation, but all of them are pretty much domain specific and siloed. And with that, you also have partial data visibility. And even in these automation tools, pretty much they are more rules based, and there is a limited use of AI ML technologies. And the need of our is actually automating distributed data and operations and analytics. And that is where RDA comes into picture. So what is RDA? It is a data-driven and intelligent IT automation platform, which is based on bots and low-code approach. With RDA, you can actually take data from any of these environments and you can apply bots and pipelines, and then you can completely do automated IT workflows, which are data-driven. So in this example, in a traditional approach, in this kind of complex IT environment, you may be doing a lot of manual data prep and integration activities, or you may have siloed automation tools. With RDA, what we are doing is we have built a library of more than 500 bots that will help you to do automated data preparation and also enable hyper automation across all of your IT environments. And you are able to do this with data bots, which are intelligent bots. So you may be wondering, what is a bot? A bot actually performs an atomic task. And these bots are repeatable and reusable. And these bots actually run in a RDA platform. So some examples are, let's say if you want to post a message to a Slack channel, we have a bot, and the way to invoke that bot is by just using the name of the bot. Here, if you want to get data from AWS environment, you can use the AWS bot. And if you want to specify a region, it can also take parameters. In the same way, we have few other data management bots. We have many different categories of bots that we have listed here. And if you go to this web page, we have listed all the bots in the bot library page. So things like connecting to IT operational tools, or doing data visualization, or doing AI ML, doing NLP, all of these are provided as bots in our library, including all the data management bots. So here is an example of some ML bots where we have integrations even with some third-party services. And you can search, you can click on that, or you can also search for a certain bot here. And we have integrations with Watson, OpenAI, and Hugging Face is also upcoming. So here are the Cisco bot integrations that we have, and including AppDynamics, Intersight, UCS, Meraki, and so on. We have built a lot of Cisco bots with Cisco integrations. And all of these bots can be used in building complex workflows and data pipelines. So what is a pipeline, right? Because a bot will allow you to do atomic tasks. And in a pipeline, you can actually arrange these multiple bots in a sequence to accomplish complex IT workflows. A typical pipeline or workflow would look like this. So first you would do data preparation or integration, and then you do some data transformations, like, you know, filtering of the data or cleaning the data, shaping or aggregating the data, converting the data. And then you will typically do some analytics, right? Using OpenAI or Watson or NLP bots. Then you may want to trigger some actions. So in these actions, you may want to trigger some third-party automation tools or workflows or runbooks, like, you know, Ansible playbooks. All of those things you can do here. And then you may want to update some third-party visualization dashboards. And then eventually you want to load the data into any analytics tool of your choice. So this is like a typical workflow that you can easily implement in RDA without writing any kind of programming language code. So in RDA, pipelines are written with low code approach, which means that you don't need to be a data scientist or a software engineer or a programming expert to implement RDA pipelines. So who uses RDA? Primarily, if you are a DevOps or SRE ops personnel, or if you are in the AI ops or IT ops, or even if you're a citizen automation developer, you can use RDA. And in RDA, it is very easy to implement these pipelines. And also it's very easy to make changes in this pipeline. In this module, I'm going to cover a couple of demo scenarios and use cases. To implement the pipelines, we have a tool called AI Ops Studio. And here you can design, test, iterate, and build all of your pipelines. In this scenario, we can detect changes happening in AWS EC2 environment. Let us see how it works. First, go to our website, roboticdata.ai. Click on the free sign up button. Provide your information, and our team will send you a link to a page where you can actually sign up for our free cloud hosted RDA version. Click on the SSO button. Click on Don't Have an Account Sign Up and complete the account creation process. So this is the AI Ops Studio with a welcome screen and links to documentation. And all the tasks you can perform from here. And typically, first you will be establishing connectivity to data sources. For example, we have added AWS and few other data sources here. And this is a one-time activity. And once you are done, then you would be typically exploring data sets. And this is a very helpful tool for exploring all of your data sets. And you can perform few other activities with related to data sets. You can also explore bots here. For example, we have a lot of Cisco bots. We have a lot of AIML bots and NLP bots that you can refer to later. And then you can also add solution packages, import and export them, and you can edit pipelines or add new pipelines. And for this demo, I'm going to focus on pipelines. So let us look at this pipeline, which tries to establish the baseline data. Here we have the AWS bots getting data from these regions. We are trying to get the metadata of the VMs, and then we are selecting the columns of our choice, and then we are saving in a baseline data set.
and then we are updating a Kibana dashboard. This is the data we have in our AWS portal. I'm looking at the South region where we have 6 VMs, 4 in running state, 2 in stopped state. And this is the dashboard that I set up with the empty data at this point. And the pipeline is very simple, right? So here we are not writing any Python code or JavaScript or Go language. It's completely markup-like language. And that's why it is very easy to implement these pipelines. And if any time you want to see the YAML format, you can also see the YAML equivalent of this pipeline. So let us go ahead and execute this pipeline. Right now, the pipeline is executing, and as it completes the execution, you will see that each of these stages, they will turn into green color once it is done. So now it is done, and you can inspect the data at any stage of the pipeline by selecting the stage. You can select the output, or you can also search for output here. And in the South region, same thing, we are seeing six VMs in and four in running state, two in stopped state. And if you go back here and update the dashboard, now the dashboard is also updated with all the summary analytics. Now let us go ahead and make a change to one of the VMs here. Say, for example, I'm selecting the Windows VM with the 7BD3 ID, and I'm going to stop this instance. Then come back here, and I have another pipeline which actually does compare the difference of the current state versus the baseline state. And we have the diff bot to do that. Now it completed the execution. It highlighted one VM, and that was that VM. Its state changed from running to stopping state. And if you go back and update this dashboard again, now you will see that the change is the VM state change, and it highlights that VM. In this scenario, we will see how we can identify end of support or end of life events on Cisco network devices and update a ServiceNow incident with this kind of insights. Let us see how this works. Here I have an incident on a Catalyst 3750 switch, and we are going to update this incident with the CI insights once it is processed. Here I have the pipeline. We are reading the incident. We have a ServiceNow bot to get the configuration item, and we have a Cisco bot to get the information about lifecycle events on the given product ID. And then we go and update the incident. And we are also applying a formatting template, which I have provided here. So let us go ahead and execute this pipeline. If you check the incident, now we have the lifecycle event insights. We have the product ID, we have the product description, the last day of support, the migration PID, and also a notice URL. In this scenario, you can identify network devices that need to be rebooted if they have not been rebooted for the past 6 months. And this is actually a network security compliance requirement from one of our customers. This is how the pipeline looks like, where we are using some of the data management bots, and we identify the list of devices, and we actually go and update the incident with those devices list. In this scenario, you can verify your network upgrades by comparing the network state before and after upgrade. And you can find if any ports have changed the state or if any MAC addresses are now appearing on different ports. Here you can establish full stack application dependency mapping using our bots for AppDynamics, Cisco UCS Manager, and VMware. This is how the topology would look like, starting all the way from the network and then going to the application layer and then plotting the topology and the connectivity in this application dependency map. In this scenario, we apply unsupervised ML clustering techniques to identify groups of similar incidents. This is how the pipeline looks like, and these are the groups of similar incidents. Here we apply NLP techniques on trouble tickets or incidents, and we also use integrations with Watson and OpenAI. This is how the pipeline looks like. This is a sample incident where we have updated the NLP insights right in the incident console itself. In this e-bonding scenario, we can actually send incident data to multiple different tools or destinations at the same time. And here we use some of the streaming techniques to do that. If you want to do facial recognition or object detection using OpenCV library, we have integration bots for that. We have many more scenarios and examples listed in these pages. And if you go to the blogs page and scroll all the way down, we have many videos here, how to get started with RDA, how to use the studio, and various other demo scenarios we have here.
In this module, I'm going to talk about some of the advanced capabilities and architecture. These are some of the sample data management operations you can do with RDA. If you want to understand the metadata of a certain data set, or if you want to shape the data, we have a lot of bots to do that. You can do data filtration, aggregation, and mapping. You can also do data security, like data masking, encryption and decryption, or you can do data integrity checks, you can do data transformations, or you can even do data delivery in multiple modes like streaming, bulk, batch modes, or you can do data enrichments, even you can do data simulations, and finally you can do data governance with the data lineage and tracing. So we have something called solution packs. These solution packs are purpose built for solving certain problems in a given industry or a vertical, or for a certain use case or a scenario. So you can see that we have the solution packs for observability, ITSM, data operations, AI ops, and so on. And here you can easily download these solution packs and start using this in RDA platform. So the deployment choice, RDA, you can deploy it in your laptop or desktop, or you can also deploy it in your data center or any public cloud, or even in some of the branch or edge environments. But we have also provided a fully managed SaaS offering, which you can pretty much sign up and be up and running in just a few minutes. And we also have a data fabric, which is one of the key capabilities and a foundational architectural component in RDA. With this data fabric, you can actually enable distributed data automation across many different environments. So if you have applications and workloads running in an edge environment, and if you need to exchange data with some cloud applications or SaaS applications, and if you want to do some local computations, then RDA provides you the capability with the data fabric. So how to get started? So it's very easy to get started with RDA. You can actually go to this link you can provide your information and sign up. It's a completely free sign up for the community edition. And I also put a video here to provide the instruction on how to get started. These are some of the resources that we have. Please go through the resources. And for help and support, here are some of the resources that are available for you to get help and support. And I hope this session was helpful, and with RDA bots, you can actually automate a lot of your IT workflows, and it is very easy to use these RDA bots. And if you need any more help or any more information, please reach out to us at any time, and enjoy the rest of the DevNet sessions. Thank you, and look forward to hearing from you soon.